I just wanted to say thank you for joining me as I set up my March planner. I'm going to be using the Coco Daisy March Planner Kit for this setup. And here I'm using the vellum that came in the kit, and I'm just fussy cutting around the flowers. As you can see, I'm just taking the largest image that I could find that was a full image, and I'm just trimming off the extras. All the white space, the other flowers. And when I'm done, I go back, just trim off a little bit of the extra white space that I decide I don't want on there anymore. Round off the edges so that you can't tell that it came from the edge of the paper. And then I'm gonna kind of fold up the edges a little bit because I want a little bit of a 3D effect from my flowers as I put them on the dashboard itself. I'm sure that you don't want to watch me fussy cut every single flower that I cut, so I decided that I would speed it up a little bit so you didn't have to watch every single one. Now I'm just trying to decide, do I want them on the top, do I want them on the bottom, do I want two lines, one line? I definitely decided to go with both on top and on the bottom. Now I'm just going to glue them down where I like them. But then I decide I want to really curl up those edges. So I use my scissors and I just kind of run it over the paper, but very lightly. I don't want to tear it. And I should have, in all reality, probably gone ahead and sped it up through this process, but unfortunately I did not. And I'm a newbie to this new YouTuber thing, so I don't know how to go back and do that. Like, I'm sure that some of the other YouTubers can absolutely do. So I'm sorry that you're just gonna have to endure. And here I decided that I wanted to cut the petals apart even more for even a better effect. And you're still suffering through all the cut, the curling. But as you can see, it's really not that time consuming. If you were to choose to do something like this, it's pretty easy and doesn't take too much time. Thank goodness for the music. Now I'm just going to take the glue and I am going to secure all my little flowers down. I started on the ends so that I could have a little bit better sense of where my flowers would be without having any extra space. finally, I think I'm happy with the way that it turned out. So now I'm going to take one of the papers. It's a double-sided paper that comes in the kit, and I'm going to adhere it to my dashboard, and I just use glue, and I just kind of dot around the edges, making sure to get the corners really good, because I will be turning the pages a lot, and I don't want them to catch. I just put glue all over the dashboard. I pick which paper I like, and then I'm deciding how I want the flowers to lay and what colors I want where. Then I just stick it on there, line up the edges, and then secure it. I like to rub all over it to make sure that the glue is stuck pretty good. You can see there's some excess paper on the edges. And I'm just going to take my scissors and I'm just going to trim that right off. I use the dashboard as my straight edge. I'm all done. Easy peasy, right? Now we're gonna do a shaker card dashboard. And I just took the material from the kit that some of the stickers had come in, and some sequins and glitter from a prior kit, and I pour them in and I secure it with washi, and then I it to the dashboard and do the same thing with the paper. Now I have my three dashboard. Now you can see how I punch all the holes using the main dashboard that comes in the kit as my template. Securing the tabs can be a little bit tricky, so I like to use the template, or the main march that comes in the kit, and the main dashboard that comes in the kit, and I use that as a template so I know where I put my tabs, that it will line up and look somewhat normal. Luckily, this glue is really forgiving and allows me to move it around just a little bit afterwards. The middle one can be even trickier, so I like to put them all together and then find my happy middle place, line it up with the other ones to make sure that the space between the edges are as close to the same as possible. Once I'm happy with that, I secure it pretty good with my fingers, pressing it down, and then I check to make sure that it looks like it's pretty centered, and it's not. So, like I said, this glue is really forgiving and allows me to move it around a little bit. And my kitty thinks that she needs to be a part of this video, I guess. Sorry about that, guys. often I just add the stickers that come in the kit to my tabs. Now I'm going to show you how I put together the Dutch door. I've already cut everything down to size, and you can always go check out the Coco Daisy blog. And I've done a couple of blog posts on how I put together my Dutch door. I will leave the link below. I love the colors that are always on the Week at a Glance. And I wasn't utilizing this page as well as I would have liked to before I decided to convert the inserts into the Dutch door. Now I'm using it so much more because, and I get to see it all the time, because I put it up top and I get to see it all week long. And then the strip that's left over, I use as my meal planning and my grocery list. I wanted to save as much of the flowers as possible, so I ended up cutting off the white, and I don't always do that. Now I'm just taking the stamps that I wanted to use, and these ones happen to be the letters, and I want to make sure that I remember when March starts. I usually mess this part up. I'm just going to stamp right down in the, well, I have to decide where I'm going to stamp it, and I end up stamping it right in the corner, so I have lots of room to write appointments and things that are going to be happening during the week. I'm going to take the daily sheet from the kit that I've already cut down to size, and I'm going to go ahead and mark the dates on each one of the sheets using the stickers that come in the add-on kit from Coco Daisy. And actually, now that I think of it, I've been a part of Coco Daisy for so long that I can't remember now if this is actually the planner kit or the add-on kit. I think it's the actual planner kit. The add-on kit has little circular numbers. at the bottom are the day of the week, and they fit perfectly right under the number banners. Here that I made a mistake, so I went ahead and stopped and showed you how I decided that I was going to fix it. I took one of the extra pieces that I had trimmed off earlier that I would use for my grocery list and my meal planning, and I just cut that down to size, measuring with my fingers, and I just covered it right up. I appreciate you all watching and would love for you to follow my channel. Just hit subscribe. Thanks, guys. Have a great day.